讲到呢，就关于那个最终的牧羊人。
I mean, some of us are amazing shepherds, you're a good CG leader, you take care of your spiritual children well, you know, but none of us can be compared to Jesus Christ Himself, who is the good shepherd and who is the one that we need to learn from. So this week is about looking at the ultimate shepherd, and the Bible calls him the good shepherd.
那我们之中呢，有些是一个很好的小组组长之类的，但是今天我们要学习的就是我们那个终极牧者，那就是我们的主耶稣，那就是好的牧人。
So before we turn to the sermon, how many of you like fun facts? You mean you like? How many of you like fun facts? Okay.
那我们还没有看我们经文之前呢，多少个人喜欢那种有趣的那种就是事情。
Okay.There, we're going to look at them. The book of, okay, first one, the book of Ezekiel is in the Old Testament or New Testament? Come on, such an easy question. Old Testament.
以西结书是在新约还是旧约呢？还是在旧约？
There are a few grouping of five books in the Old Testament. Five books here, five books there, five books. The category of five books for those who do not know.
在旧约里面呢，有不同的种类，就是说有五本书是关于这个类型的，另外五本是关于这个类型的。
Okay, the first fun fact, the first five books in the Old Testament, okay, it is called the Pentateuch.
这个我不知道怎样翻译。
Pentateuch 啦，就是 Pentateuch。
Pentateuch 啦。
All right, it's also known as the Torah.Torah. All right. So the first, not the whole of the whole of the Bible, the 66 books is called the Logos. Can somebody say Logos? Okay, we are not talking about that. Okay, so when you group the first five books, it's also this Pentateuch, this Torah is also known as the Book of the Law.
那刚才牧师所讲的那些书呢，在圣经就是在我们的圣经里面呢是就是我想不起。
Okay, what's the first book of the Bible? Second? Third? Fourth? Fifth? So the names of our CGs, the name of this, our CG, the five, we have five CGs, and it's actually named after the Pentateuch. And as we have the sixth one, then it's going to be called Joshua. Joshua, the sixth book of the Bible, is not part of the Torah.Okay, it's not part of the Pentateuch. It's not part of the Book of Law.
那我们的就是在圣经里面呢，前五本书呢，就是创世纪、出埃及记、利末记、民数记，还有生命记呢，其实就是代表我们的那个小组的名称呢。
Have you heard this phrase, "People of the Book"? Have you heard the phrase, "People of the Book"? Yes or no? Okay, it's okay. One person only. It doesn't matter.
那你有听过？刚不是。
People of the book are the primary religions of the world, which is the Muslim faith, the Christian faith, and the Jewish faith.
那牧师所说那个 people of the book 呢，就是有代表不同的那种宗教穆斯林等等。
All of these three groups of the people of the books, they all believe in, they believe that the Pentateuch, the Torah,The Book of Laws, the five books of the Holy Bible is God's word.
那穆斯林呢？犹太啊，还有另外一个的话，他们相信的就是那五本不同的。
Did you know?
前面的。
Did you know that? That the Muslims also believe in the Pentateuch, the Jewish religion also believe in the Pentateuch, and so do we. So this is something we have in common. The first five books is very. I mean, every book.In the scriptures is precious, but the first five books is there, is situated as the first five books, not the second five, but the first five, it's there, it's situated in such a way for a beautiful purpose.
那刚才我们所说的那五本书呢，就是摩西五经 ，OK， 它是在圣经里面是有它的意思，有它的意思的。
And right smack in the middle of the Bible, there's another five books. This is you should know because I bring this up all the time.
那在圣经中间呢，就有那五本书。那通常很多时候牧师都会提起。
This is another fun fact. What's the five books in the middle of the Bible? What is it called? No, not to give you the names of the book. Well, what is it called? The books of what? The books of wisdom is also called the book of poems. You know, the book of wisdom. Okay?
那中间的五本书呢，就是智慧的书。
Another five. What are the names of the five books of wisdom? What's the first one? Job. That's right. Second? Psalms. Third? Proverbs. Fourth? Ecclesiastes. Fifth? The fifth one has two names. Songs of Solomon, or it is also known as Songs of Song. Okay, it's the same thing. So the five books. Everybody say another five books. Okay.
那现在我们所说的五本智慧的书呢，就包括了约伯记、诗篇、箴言、传道书和所罗门之歌，或者说雅歌。
So after the five books of wisdom, there is another five books, and Ezekiel falls in this grouping of the next five books. Everybody say next five books.
Next five books. 那接下来的另外五本书呢，是就是今天我们的讲到的这以西结，也是在这五本书之内。
Can I give you the name of the books first? Okay, so after Songs of Solomon, we have Isaiah, Jeremiah, not Jeremy. As Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentation, Ezekiel, and Daniel.
那五本智慧书过后呢？这五本书是它的名称，就是以赛亚、耶利米、哀歌、以西结和但以理。
And it's good for you to know this because, as believers, it's good to know that the why these books are grouped in five, why they are here, why they are there. So these five books that comes after the books of wisdom, it's called the five major prophetic books. There's a lot of words. Everybody say it with me. Five major prophetic books.
那很重要，身为信徒的我们呢，需要知道为什么那些书会聚集在一起，成为那五本不同的种类的。然后这个我们所说的五本啊书呢，就是五个很著名的预言的书。
How many books are there?
Five.
But there are only four major prophets. The books are known as five major prophetic books. But how many prophets are there in that five books? Four prophets.
那这里面有五本预言书，对不对？可是五本里面呢，有四个，只有四个先知。
These are fun facts, but very, very important information. The first prophet would be Isaiah.
那这是很重要的那个真正的事实呢？那就是说，第一个是以赛亚。
And the second book is Jeremiah.
第二是耶利米。
These are major prophets. The third book is not a prophet.The third book among these five is called Lamentation. Can somebody say Lamentation?
Lamentation. 那第三本书叫哀歌，它不是一个先知的。
Lamentation simply means the cry, the cry. And who's crying here? Lamentation is the cry of the second prophet. What's the second prophet's name? Jeremiah's cry. It's Jeremiah's Lamentation.Right smack in the middle of the five books of the major prophets. Are you following?
Yeah. 那我们讲所说的那第三本哀歌呢，它其实是一个呼喊，就是个哭哀号。它是耶利米先知，就是第二本书的他的哀歌。
And the third major prophet is the prophet that we are looking at today, Ezekiel. Okay, that's the third major prophet.
那第三个很大的先知呢，就是以西结，就是今天我们所要说的。
And the next one, the last, the fourth major prophet will be Daniel. Everybody say Daniel.
Na 第四位主要的那个大先知呢，就是但以理。
There are five. There are few reasons why they are called major prophets. And after the major prophet books, after the five books comes the minor prophet books.
那有原因的，他们被叫做就是大预言家。那过大预言就是这五本书过后呢，也有一个这个比较次要的。
One of the major reasons why these five books are called the major prophetic books because the books these five books are longer than the rest of the books that come after these books. So they are called minor. That's one of the reasons.
那其中一个原因为什么他们是就叫做这样子呢？因为他们的就本身就比较长的，在那个不同的书里面，如果我们跟那个过后的那些书本来比较的话
，Is that too much information? No? Okay, do you like the fun facts? Yeah, so if you want to go through that again, then Deacon Didi will share the notes. She will share the notes on Wednesday. Then you will see those information in the notes. These are great fun facts to know. I mean, I love Bible fun facts. You know, Bible fun facts are interesting because the Bible should be very close to our hearts.
那这些有趣的事实呢，就是在牧师的讲道里面，在星期三我会分享在我们的脸书上面，然后你可以在那边参考。
Let's turn to verse 1 of this precious, precious chapter, Ezekiel chapter 34. Verse 1 says, "And the word of the Lord came to me." So these are prophets. Prophets means they hear from God and they speak to the people. They hear the Old Testament. In the Old Testament, the Holy Spirit did not live inside people generally. Only special people. Like today we are New Covenant believers. We all have the Holy Spirit. Can somebody say amen? We all can hear the Holy Spirit. So in the Old Testament, only certain people and one of the groups will be prophets. So God will speak to the prophet and the prophet will speak to the people. No, you know, it's commonly done that way.
那在旧约的时候呢，神是怎么人民说话？他通过某些人就是预言来对人民说话。现在我们这新约的信徒，我们不需要，我们只要通过圣灵，我们就可以与神说话。
So the introduction, verse 1 of this chapter, you can see who is actually talking to the people. It's not a trick question. Who is talking to the people actually? It is God, the Lord. Can somebody say the Lord? So Ezekiel is just a mouthpiece. As a prophet, if we are a prophet, we are a preacher, we are a teacher, don't show off. Okay, Reverend Edmund, don't show off. I don't show off. Hallelujah. Thank you. It is God. We are just a mouthpiece. Can somebody say mouthpiece? And we are to take it seriously when we hear God speaking. God is speaking. Today, God is speaking to us through Ezekiel. God, so take this chapter seriously. Not just today, but the whole week, if I were you, please dive into Ezekiel chapter 34 to see what God is saying to us. It's relevant.
那以西结书第三十四章第一个呢，就是告诉我们，其实就是耶和华在对我们说话，他是通过那个以西结来对我们说话。所以今天如果你是牧师啊，或者说你在前面的话，你不需要感到骄傲，因为其实我们只是上帝用我们来对他的人民说话而已。
Okay, let's go to the next verse, but the first part of next verse, I'm going to break that verse into two A. We'll see, son of man. Okay, God is speaking to Ezekiel. Prophesy against the shepherds of Israel. Okay, so we are not shepherds of Israel, but we are shepherds of the body of Christ. So I always say, when you turn to the Old Testament today, you got to read with new covenant lenses. Can somebody say amen? He's the same God yesterday, today, and tomorrow. So whatever God says, a lot of things, nearly everything that God says to Israel, He is speaking to the body of Christ today. So that is why God purposely has the Old Testament in our hands. Not to study history, but to tell us. I told my people then, I'm telling my people now. So you see the word Israel, don't be silly and say, I'm not Israel. In fact, we are Israel. The Bible clearly says that we are the spiritual children of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Who can say amen? So we are Israel. He's directly speaking to us. But as new covenant believers, we look at it as He's speaking to the body of Christ today.
那接下来呢，就是在我们的34章第二节的上半段呢，就是上帝在对他的人说，其实那个所谓的以色列呢，其实是代表他的人民。
So we read that again. Son of man, prophesy against the shepherds. I mean, God is not happy with the shepherds, with some shepherds. The first part of this chapter is God is rebuking the shepherds, and God is rebuking us. God is rebuking some of us, shepherds of Israel. Prophesy and say to them, thus says the Lord God to the shepherds.
我读一下第三章二节的上部分。人子啊，你要说预言，攻击以色列众牧者，你要对他们说预言。主耶和华这样说。
I said this before, and I'm going to say this again. Every Christian, every true believer is called to be a shepherd. Yes, you start as a sheep.If you're a new Christian, like Auntie Chandra, you're a new Christian, then you have the right to be a sheep. You're a baby Christian. But you cannot be a sheep forever. Yeah, you need to be a sheep of Jesus forever, but you need to grow to become a shepherd. You need to take care. Shepherd means you take care of the sheep. Sheep means you are being taken care of. But we, every sheep, need to grow. So as you listen to this sermon,As you ponder on the chapter this week, you have to ask yourself, are you shepherding? You have been hearing this season. Are you shepherding? There are cliques of yours that you can shepherd. There are family members in your house that you can shepherd. That means you can take care of them. There are friends in your life that you can shepherd. So there's no excuse. I don't know who to shepherd. Are you crazy? There's so many people around us.There's so many. Some Christians even go on the street and look for sheep. Do you know that? They go on street evangelism. They go knocking door to door. They're looking for sheep. So there are sheep everywhere. So all of us, if you say I'm a true Christian, you need to be shepherding at least one sheep. But don't remain at one. Continue to shepherd one sheep, two sheep, three sheep. Are you listening?So don't just learn this powerful message from Ezekiel and just listen to a good sermon and go back to square one. Every one of us. Yes, you started as sheep, but you need to continue to go, move forward and start eating meat and become a shepherd. So are you a shepherd?
那身为信徒的我们呢，如果我们相信主耶稣的话，我们开始呢是羊群，我们是羊群，我们需要就是被牧养，然后呢，可是我们成长过后呢，我们不可能一直停留成为一个羊而已，我们需要成为一个牧者。然后你看你身边的，不管你的同事也好，你家里的亲朋好友，你的邻居也好，都是可以让你去牧养的。
So the next few verses, you got to pay attention. If you're already a shepherd, pay attention.If you are going to be a shepherd, pay attention. CG leaders, pay attention. You are a shepherd. By default, you automatically become a CG leader or CG support. If you are in the leadership of the CG, you are a shepherd. So the next few verses is a rebuke that to make sure this is not you. You don't be this kind of shepherd. Pay attention.
那接下来我们要读的呢，是给那些如果今天你是一个牧养者，你可能是小组组长，你可能是就是协助在那个小组里面的人。我们今天要来注意听这个我们要说的话。
I'm going to read. We are going to read a few verses, and then from these verses, you will see clearly that shepherds are supposed to do this, and shepherds are not supposed to. So don't think of yourself. My job as a shepherd. Every Thursday, I show up. Listen.Every Thursday I show up in my CG, I just talk, 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 talk. That's my, no, it's more than that. Shepherds take care of the sheep. Okay, let's look.
那我们身为牧者呢，好像如果小组组长的话，不要以为我们只是星期四来到小组说说一些话就而已。不是的，我们要照顾我们的羊群。我们来看
Verse 2b. Woe! Woe means like curse. Woe!Watch out, woe! Woe to the shepherds of Israel who feed themselves. Should not the shepherds feed the flocks? You are busy feeding yourself. It can also mean you are busy feeding yourself spiritually. You are growing spiritually. It can also mean you are taking care of your stomach only. You care what you eat, but you do not care. You do not feed the flocks. Means you do not feed the sheep. So think.Shepherd, future shepherds, Reverend Edmund, Brother Jeremy, Elder Elena, pastors, are you just busy feeding yourselves? CG leaders, are you busy feeding yourselves? The Bible's God says through the prophet Ezekiel, shepherds are supposed to feed the sheep. Prajeev, feed the sheep. Feed the sheep. Susie, feed the sheep. Deacon Joe, sailing.Feed Moses, feed the sheep. Every, doesn't matter, even non-CG leaders. If you are a shepherd on an unofficial manner. That means you are outside, you are shepherding your colleagues or your family members or your friends. And you need to make sure that you are feeding the sheep. It's the first thing. The first rebuke is you got to feed. And I believe primary speaks about spiritual food. You need to make sure your sheep are growing.
第三，以西结书第三四章第二节的下部分，以色列众牧者有祸了，他们只顾牧养自己，牧者岂不应当牧养羊群吗？这个告诉我们什么呢？就是说，不管你是小组组长也好，身为一个信徒的我们呢，要去牧养你的羊群，你身边的人，照顾别人，而是不是只是照顾自己，就是特别在属灵方面。
David feed the sheep. When? Feed your sheep. Ken, feed your sheep. James, feed your sheep. You say RBDC, feed your sheep.
RBDC, 记得牧养你的羊群。
Okay, verse 3. You eat the fat and clothe yourselves with the wool. You slaughter the fatlings, but you do not feed the flock.
第三节，你们吃脂油，穿羊毛，宰肥壮的羊，却不牧养羊群。
Verse 4, the weak you have not strengthened, nor have you healed those who were sick, nor bound up the broken, nor brought back what was driven away, nor sought what was lost, but with force and cruelty you have ruled them.
第四节，瘦弱的你们没有养壮，患病的你们没有医治，受伤的你们没有包扎，被赶散的你们没有领回，迷失的你们没有寻找，你们反而用强暴严严的管辖他们。
And I pray that all of us will allow the Holy Spirit to truly teach us, okay, shepherds, future shepherds, all of us, not just CG leaders, every one of us are called to be shepherds. Take this, allow the Holy Spirit to check our hearts and our shepherding ministry. This is serious. God is speaking to us.
那牧者，未来的牧羊人，让圣灵来在我们检查我们，因为这是很重要的事情。让我看一下，让圣灵来到我们，我们是怎么样去牧养我们的羊群的。
So from these verses, we can come up with 5 points. The first 4 points would be what we are supposed to do, and then the 5th point is what we are not to do. So follow me. I'm going to give you 5 points here from the verses that we just read, from 2b to 4. Okay, in Ezekiel, we have 5 points. The first 4 points is as shepherds, what we are supposed to do, and the 5th one, as shepherds, what we are not to do.
然后就是在第二节下部分到第四节呢，有四个东西是告诉我们成为牧者应该怎么做的。然后最后一个点呢，就是我们不应该做什么。
So the first one, okay, shepherds should spiritually feed our sheep and not being busy feeding and clothing ourselves.
那第一个，身为牧者的话，牧养人的话，我们应该做的就是去牧养我们的羊群在属灵方面，而不是只是忙碌的在养着自己而已。
So if as shepherds you don't study the sermon, you don't study the chapter, you just lenga, you come on Thursday, okay, and then you just do whatever you can. That's not the right attitude. You need to study the word. You need to study the sermon. You're going to teach. You're going to discuss. You got to be ready. Okay, and I say this again. It's not just Thursdays. As shepherds, we are to lead. God is about to lead us. Believers are shepherds. Okay, victory disciples are shepherds. Many of you are shepherds, even maybe you don't even catch it at the moment. So feeding your sheep is very important, feeding them.
那身为牧者呢，例如小组组长的话，星期四呢是要准备的，而不是说随随便便的就来到那个我们来讨论的环节呢，就随便的这样子的话，是需要准备的。不管你是牧者，是任何一个方面的话。
Second point, yes, every sheep is important, but God is saying to Ezekiel, give attention to those who are especially weak, those who have no strength. So you cannot, I mean, everyone is important, but you look, this person is weak, this person has no strength, and it means a lot of things. It may not just necessarily means weak physically, it can be weak spiritually. So if your sheep A is doing pretty fine, okay, you don't have to, you can just give some attention. But sheep B is pretty weak, okay, weak and have no strength. You need to give attention. So as shepherd, you have to be, you have to discern, you have to observe. You don't treat everybody the same. This person is mentally challenged. Different. This person is a senior. Old. So you got to say, oh, everybody have to be the same. This person is peculiar. Whatever, like, you know, you as you got to use those things. Okay? And God put those sheep in your life for a reason. And very often those sheep are in your life that because God wants you to learn something from that experience. Are you listening? It's not just God purposely put this handicapped person in your under your shepherding ministry. God purposely put him or her so that you can learn certain things from this experience. You can grow from it. Instead of murmuring, why God put this kind of people under me? Reverend Edmund, very bad. You know, but you look at it as, okay, God wants me to learn. Oh, Pastor Cheryl, very bad. Put this person in my CG or what? You know, because God wants you to benefit from this shepherding ministry with this special, through this special person who is weak or have no strength.
那第二个就是身为牧者呢，我们就是要特别的给一些专关注呢，对于那些比较瘦弱、比较弱的，弱的可能就在他属灵方面，或者说可能在他是一个就是年长的人呐、啊，可能他的就是他的智慧方面有一些限制啊。这些人被放在我们的那个小组里面呢，是有原因的，而不是说哦，为什么我们的牧师这不公平，把这些人放在我们小组里面？但是其实他是要我们从这里面呢来学习的。
The third thing that shepherds need to learn from God through Ezekiel here is shepherds should bring healing to our sheep that are sick and binding up the sheep that are broken. Okay, you know certain sheep are sick. They are broken. You got to look into it. It can be sexually broken. It can be emotionally broken. And some of you are doing a fantastic job. You know you are who you are. But some of you just ignoring the brokenness of your sheep. Like, that's wrong. We are to bring healing, says the word of God, not me, and to the sick and binding up the sheep. Binding means bandage up. It can be physically, it can be spiritually, it can be emotionally, doing counseling and all that. The sheep that are broken.
第三个，身为一个牧羊人呢，我们要去看顾的就是带来医治。那医治所谓医治什么呢？就是可能在他的属灵方面，可能在他的就是他有一些破碎，在他的情感方面，在他的性方面有破碎，我们要就是置之不理的。
And the fourth one is very interesting, which some people don't want to hear. Listen, okay, this is in the Bible. I didn't make this up. It's all in the scriptures. Shepherds should bring back our sheep that has been driven away or got lost. And that Deacon Tina did a fantastic is doing a fantastic job with Ellie. So this is an example. That person who used to be in the Lord, person who used to be in church but lost. Okay, has been driven away for whatever reason, for some demonic reason. But you look out, you bring them back. You say, I'm going to die, I don't care lah. You leave the ministry, pergi mampus lah kau. It's not my business. That's not biblical. That's not biblical. Based on the word, we need to look out those who are lost. Maybe if you can't do much, you can start praying. And God will start working. And then you need to respond to God, what God is calling you to do. Instead of saying, you know, you left your business law. You know, but based on the word of God, I read that again. Shepherds should bring back our sheep that has been driven away for whatever reason and are lost.
那第四，作为一个牧羊人呢，牧羊者很重要，就是把那些可能被驱赶走了，这不管什么原因也好，或者那些迷失的那些羊群呢带回来。就像迪根啊 Tina 在做的，就是其中有一个我们的一个就是一个人，他之前已经迷失了，但是呢，他在做的工作就是把他带回这个神的国度里面。也许可能你做不到什么，但你可以做的一件事情就是为他祷告。
So it's good. Some of you say, "Yo, I'm called Reverend Edmund. Put me as a shepherd. I don't know how, what it means." Today, God is giving you the answer. From Ezekiel chapter 34, you get the answer. And the timing is right. God is bringing forth this message. What it means to be a shepherd.
Now, 也许你说，牧师把我 成为一个，就让我成为一个牧者，可是我不知道怎么去牧养我的羊群。今天呢，以西结书就告诉你如何去牧养你的羊群。
So the fifth point is the do not do. The first four points is what you need to do. Okay, the fifth point is do not do. Okay, as shepherd, we are not called to force or be cruel and rule over our sheep. You cannot force. Okay, you can invite them.You can love on them, pray their hearts will change. But the Bible says here, we are not called to force, to be cruel, and to rule. Like, I am your shepherd. What I tell you to do, you need to do. That's wrong. That's not biblical. That's not the kind of shepherd that Jesus wants us to be.
那刚我们所说的第一到第四点，就是身为牧者应该做的事情。最后的第五点呢，是告诉我们身为牧者不应该做的。我们不应该用强逼的手段啊，去逼迫他们，用残忍的手段来逼他们就做事情，就因为我们是一个牧者。
So I say this again, you know, this sermon is not just for those who are serving Jesus as shepherds. Okay, for those of you who are not, you need to rise up.So as listen to this sermon carefully and start to ask the Holy Spirit, which is that one person I can start to shepherd in my life? It can be a family member, it can be a friend, a neighbor, someone at your workplace. And as you listen to this sermon this week, not just now, then you start using this, the things that God wants you to use or to be and use this. So don't shepherd sebarang buta. Don't shepherd any way you like. You shepherd God biblically. Can somebody say amen?So in Ezekiel 34, you will learn, oh, this is how the biblical way to shepherd my sheep.
那今天我们看到了以西结书呢，就是上帝在告诉我们，身为牧者，可能你是未来的牧者也好，来告诉我们，教导我们怎么样成为一个牧者，怎么去牧养我们的羊群，而不是是盲目的去牧养，那是用神圣的方式。那这里以西结书就可以告诉我们。
Let's go to verse 5.And the word of God that comes to us from God Himself to the prophet Ezekiel. Listen. So they were scattered because there was no shepherd. And they became food for all the beasts of the field when they were scattered.
第五节，他们没有牧人，就分散了，做了田野一切走兽的食物。
So we need to understand that the sheep, it's not enough to say, hey, come on, you want to accept Jesus Christ? Listen, you want to accept Jesus Christ? I pray for you, you accept. Okay, now you are saved, not my business. You, every new believer is a sheep, and they need to be shepherd. It's cruel of you.To bring someone to accept Jesus and say, you do whatever you like now. You need to bring them to church. You need to understand that they need to be shepherd. If not, they will be devoured by beasts of the field. Do you understand? So it's not enough to go strict evangelism or talk about, oh, they're so excited to accept Jesus. Okay, bye-bye, it's not my business now. They need to come to church. They need to be here. They need to be shepherd. So every sheepneeds to be shepherd. That's how it's supposed to be done biblically. Not, you know, not do whatever you like. So sheep, if not being shepherd, they will be eaten as food, the Bible says, by the beasts of the field.
那第五节其实告诉我们呢，如果好像说我们为一个人祷告，然后他就接受耶稣了，然后我们就说哦再见拜拜就完了，其实不是这样子的。身为一个牧者呢，我们需要照顾他，在属灵方面我们要带领他，不然的话他就会被，就是在第五节看到的，就被那些野兽所吞食。
So the verse that we just read and the following verses, this speaks about people who are God's sheep. That means they are believers, but they are not being shepherded. Okay, let's go to verse 6.Verse 6 says, My sheep wandered through all the mountains and on every high hill. Yes, my flock was scattered over the whole face of the earth, and no one was seeking or searching for them.
其实第五跟第六节是代表那些没有被牧养的羊群。我读下第六节，我的羊在众山和各高岗上流离，他们分散在全地上，没有人去寻，也没有人去找。
Verse 7, Therefore you shepherds, hear the word of the Lord.
第七节，因此你们这些做牧者的要听耶和华的话。
And I will confidently say, if you have been a Christian for 1 year plus, it's time for you to shepherd. God is speaking to you this morning. Okay, you don't need 3 years, 10 years. If 1 year you have been a Christian already, it's time for you to seriously say, Lord, show me, Holy Spirit, teach me to be a shepherd. And God is speaking to you this morning.
然后我很有信心的说，如果今天你已经成为一个基督徒一年了，你就可以成为牧者了。让圣灵，让耶稣来带领你如何成为一个牧者。
You speak to someone, maybe say, and then you find out that person is a Christian. Then you say, Are you going to church? No, I'm not going to church. Oh, that's the reason why you ask that person that question. There's a reason why God put that person in your life. Yes, I'm a Christian, but I stopped going to church. If you're not going to church, then how in the world are you being a shepherd? Okay, so you got to be sensitive in things like this. Okay, so yeah, there's no coincidence in your life. It's always Christ's incidence.
例如说，你今天问一个人，哎，你已经相信耶稣了吗？他说是的。然后问他你有没有去教会，他没有去教会。然后今天你问那个人问题呢，其实这不是一个凑巧的，是神是要利用你来带领这个人的。也许
Verse 8. As I live, says the Lord God, surely because my flock became a prey, because they have no shepherd, and my flock became food for every beast of the field, because there was no shepherd, nor did my shepherd search for my flock, but the shepherds fed themselves and did not feed my flock.
第八节，我指着我的永生起誓，我的羊因没有牧人，就成了猎物，做了田野一切走兽的食物。我的众牧者不寻找我的羊，他们只顾牧养自己，却不牧养我的羊。这是主耶和华的宣告。
Even someone as young as Jasher, you know, you can start to think how to shepherd. Maybe one friend in your school, you can say, show me. Not just have friends and have fun.You know, go for your band practice, but be sensitive. Say, God, which boy should I shepherd? And you start to just be that person's friend and love that person, even pray for that person, and of course, invite that person to church. So that's it. No matter how young you are, as someone as old as Auntie Girl there, Auntie Girl is shepherding. I know my mom, she is shepherding. She's shepherding a lot of her friends.She pray with them. They will come to her for counseling. She will visit them. So there's no age limit. As young as Jasher, as old as Auntie Girl, or even older, there's no excuse. Every one of us have people in our lives, and we are to ask the Holy Spirit how to shepherd them.
不管我们年轻或长老，如 Jasher 那么年轻的话，或者说 Andy 哥就长老的长的比较成长的一辈呢，在我们的圈子里面呢，就让圣灵来带领我们去牧养那个人。
So people like Shahin say, my English is not good. Then you say, God, send me the Iranians. There's a lot of Iranians in Malacca. You can shepherd the Iranians. I cannot shepherd the Iranian. I cannot speak Persian. So in other words, there's no excuse.Everyone can be in the lookout for the people that God wants us to shepherd. Can somebody say amen? Amen. Everyone, hallelujah.
作为信徒的我们是没有借口的。例如说我们的那个同我们的Shahin的话，他是伊朗人，我们不会说伊朗话。他可以啊，他可以去，就是让圣灵来带领他去牧养那他们的人。
Tell the person beside you, come on, seriously.Don't make excuses. Come on, say it. Don't make excuses.
告诉你身边的人，不要找借口。
Ethan and Coben tell each other, don't make excuses. Don't make excuses. You can bring your friends to YG. Okay, you have so many friends. Bring them to the youth group. Don't make excuses. There's so many. Auntie Lucy have walking friends. Walk. Don't make excuses. So it's not enough. Don't be satisfied with the little music you play, the little sound you make, the technician there, Brother Chris. Don't, not enough. You need to shepherd. You need to shepherd. I'm already the backup vocals, says Priscilla. Contoh saja lah. She didn't say, no need for me to shepherd. No, Priscilla. You are in form six. There's so many souls there. How many of them are not in Christ? You know, so Fina, all of us can be used by God. All of us must be used by God.
我们不要对自己有那个借口。其实我们身边呢，不管我们什么领域都好呢，让圣灵来带领我们。我们可以邀请他们来我们的青少年团契啊，来教会等等的。
You see the empty chair beside you? Your sheep need to be sitting there with you. Santa, your sheep need to be sitting there with you. Okay? Every one of us, every one of us.
如果今天看到你旁边有一个空的位置呢，你的羊呢，就是应该坐在这里的。
Then verse 9, therefore, O shepherds, hear the word of the Lord. Listen to what Reverend Ed is preaching this morning. That's what this verse 9 is telling you. Therefore, O shepherds, hear the word of the Lord.
第九节，因此你们这些做牧者的要听耶和华的话。今天就是我们牧师要对你们所说的话。
Okay, let's go to verse 11. I'm skipping a few verses, not because they're not important, but you just go for the context of what I want about to say, then I'm going to verse 11 to 16. Let's read a few verses. Pay attention. Verse 11. For thus says the Lord God, indeed I myself will search for my sheep and seek them out.
我们接下来跳到第十一节，因为主耶和华这样说，看啊，我必亲自寻觅我的羊，把他们找出来。
Can you see how important shepherding is? God says, if my earthly, my spiritual shepherds, if my believers is not going to be shepherds, I will have no choice, I will have to do it. But God's choice is for you to shepherd. But shepherding is a must. Shepherding is so serious that because many of you are not doing it, God says, I will have to do it. But that is not God's original plan. God calls us to shepherd one another. Can somebody say amen? But it is so serious that Christians are not shepherding. God says, I will have to intervene. And why? You got to catch why? So God's business. No, because shepherding is so important. Shepherding is vital. That is why God says, you don't do it. I have no choice. I'll do it.
很多信徒呢，现在就是没有牧养羊群，所以今天你看到这个这章的这个条文呢是很重要的，因为如果我们不做的话，其实上帝的原意就是要他的人，他的牧养人来去牧养羊群的。
It's a beautiful thing when we partner with the Holy Spirit. It's a beautiful, the perfect, the ideal would be for us to partner with the Holy Spirit and do our shepherding ministry, not just leave it to God.I pray, you're going to do the work. No. Partner with the Holy Spirit and begin to shepherd the people in your Garden of Eden beautifully.
那如何牧养呢？其实跟圣灵合作，让圣灵来带领你，而不是说啊，神我祷告，然后你做工啊。是的，是我们与圣灵来一起合作。
Verse 12. As a shepherd seeks out his flock on the day he is among his scattered sheep.So I will seek out my sheep and deliver them from all the places where they were scattered on a cloudy and dark day.
第十二节，牧人在他的羊群四散的时候，怎样寻找他的羊，我也必照样寻找我的羊。这些羊在密云幽暗的日子四散到各处，我要把他们从那里救回来。
I just heard this. The Lord tell somebody needs to hear this.Okay, your neighbor, that neighbor of yours is your neighbor for a reason. I mean, all of us have neighbor. But somebody needs to hear this. I just sense the Holy Spirit saying, your neighbor is your neighbor for a reason. Somebody just needs to hear this. God is speaking to you. Okay, your neighbor is your neighbor for a reason. It's not coincidence. God purposely put those people as your neighbor for a reason. And the reason is related to shepherding.
你们当中的某一位呢，必须要听这句话，就是说，你的邻居今天成为你的邻居是有原因的。那今天那个原因就在今天我们所说的啊讲道里面。
Verse 13, and I will bring them out from the peoples and gather them from the countries, and will bring them to their own land. I will feed them on the mountains of Israel, in the valley and in the inhabited places of the country.
第十三节，我必把他们从万族中领出来，从列邦中聚集他们，领他们回归回 故土，我必在以色列的群山上，在众溪水旁，在国内一切居住的地方牧养他们。
You have to correlate these verses with the earlier verses. You see, the earlier verses God says, "You must do this, you must do that." So now it's not what he's saying because you don't do it, so I will do it. Because shepherding ministry is a must.
那其实牧养是一个必须要做的事情。上帝说了，如果你不要做，我会做的。
Verse 14, I will feed them in good pasture, and their fold shall be on the high mountains of Israel. There they shall lie down in a good fold and feed in rich pasture of the mountains of Israel.
第十四节，我必在美好的草场上牧养他们，以色列高山必作牧放他们的地方，在那里他们必躺卧在美好的牧场上，他们必在以色列群山肥美的草场上吃草。
Verse 15, compare attention, God says, I will feed my flock, and I will make them lie down, says the Lord God.
第十五节，我必亲自牧养我的羊，亲自使他们躺卧，这是主耶和华的宣告。
Verse 16, I will seek what was lost and bring back what was driven away, bind up their broken and strengthen what was sick, but I will destroy the fat and the strong and feed them in judgment.
第十六节，迷失的我必寻找，被赶散的我必领回，受伤的我必包扎，患病的我必养壮，肥壮的我却要除灭，我也必按着公正牧养他们。
Because of time, the ending part of this chapter is speaks about Jesus. Okay, Ezekiel, come on, listen. It was prophesied by Ezekiel that there will come the ultimate shepherd, the good shepherd. He is the son of David. Who is the son of David? Who is the son of David? Jesus is the son of Jesus is known as the son of David. Jesus comes from the line of David. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
So in the last part, I'm not going to go there. I'm going to skip that part because of time, but I'm going to go somewhere else. I want to end with something else here. Okay, but you go back and you read the whole chapter, you will see that. So what is the word is saying? So when you want to learn to be a great shepherd, learn from Jesus. That's the first. Jesus is the one to how Jesus shepherd the people. That's how we are to be. Can somebody say amen?
那以西结书三十四章的最后呢，在最后下部分呢，就是其实它的总结论是告诉我们，耶稣基督就是那最好的牧者。我们要成为一个好的牧者，我们就要向耶稣来学习。
And the second thing to learn is that for those of you who feel, those of you like me, you feel like.I don't have a shepherd, what? Nobody is shepherding me. But we have the good shepherd shepherding us. Can somebody say amen? The good shepherd is Jesus. So don't fret or feel like, nobody is shepherding me. No. The best shepherd. If no one's going to shepherd us, Jesus will just come and shepherd us. But don't take that as an excuse to not shepherd. Because we see clearly in the Bible, we are called to shepherd.To shepherd others. But for those of you, you feel I'm so alone, nobody's shepherding me, you don't fret because the good shepherd is shepherding us. He's there. Say hallelujah.
第二点的话就是说，可能你们当中说，哦，没有人来牧养我啊。那其实我们最好的那个牧者呢，就是我们耶稣基督。可是呢，我们也不要说，因为没有人牧养我，我就有一个借口不去牧养别人。
Okay, I'm going to end with this verse 17. Okay, verse 17 says, "And as for you, my flock, thus says the Lord God, behold, I shall judge between sheep and sheep, between rams and goats."
然后第十七节呢，就是那个节录我今天要说的。我的羊啊，论到你们，主耶和华这样说：我要在羊与羊之间，在公绵羊与公山羊之间施行审判。
So there's two kinds of judgment here you see from this verse, and this is a powerful revelation that I received while preparing the sermon. Let's go to the later one. There's a former one. God's going to judge between sheep and sheep.But the later one, God's going to judge between sheep and goats. So a lot of Christians understand the later judgment. The day will come and God's going to judge. Who are the goats and who are the sheep? All of you are familiar with that, right? We hear this preaching over and over again. God's going to judge. Who are the goats and who are the sheep? How many of you are familiar with that? Okay, true believers are sheep. Anyone who rejects Jesus, you are goats. That's what the Bible says. That judgment, most Christians are familiar.
那十七节呢，有两种审判。第一呢，就是在绵羊与绵羊之间；第二呢，就是山羊跟绵羊之间的不同的一个审判。
And what's the former judgments between what sheep and sheep? Can somebody say sheep and sheep?
绵羊与绵羊之间的审判。
So there are two sheep here in front of me, Pastor Amanda and Elder Elena. So we always think, oh, God's going to judge between the sheep and the goats. But it's prophesied in Ezekiel that even between the sheep, who is the real sheep and who's not the real sheep? The real sheep will be the one who actually becomes a shepherd based on the context of this sermon. A sheep, for example, Pastor Amanda is just a sheep. She's too lazy to be a shepherd. She's too busy with a lot of other things. She's just enjoying herself being a sheep. But Elder Elena is a sheep, but she's also gets grown and allowing herself to be a shepherd. Are you listening? So God is going to be pleased. If that's the case, then God's going to be pleased with Elder Elena. God is not just going to judge between the sheep and the goats, but God is, it's in the scriptures, God is only also going to judge between you all. So not enough that I'm a sheep, I'm said God's going to judge between sheep and sheep. Are you following? So don't just say I'm a sheep, I'm a Christian, I'm going to church every Sunday, but you are so busy with your life. God's going to judge the sheep and sheep. So this to me is an eye-opening. So it's not enough to be a sheep, God is going to judge. Are you a sheep who is allowing yourself to be a shepherd or not? Or are you just a sheep shaking your legs and enjoying your life as a sheep? Wake up, O sheep. It's time for you to rise up to be a shepherd, says the word of God.
然后呢，通常我们所知道的审判就是说，山羊跟绵羊之间的审判。绵羊呢，就代表就是已经相信主耶稣的，山羊就是代表还没有信主的。可是，在绵羊与绵羊之间呢，神也是会有审判的。例如，我们做那个例子是说，阿瑟曼达跟Elder Elena， 就是说可能他们两个都是已经是绵羊了，已经是个牧羊者了，但是他们所做的可以就是上帝会来审判他们的。
I want you all to look around in your church. Here in the mother church, look around. Satellite church, look at each other. Look around. Mother church, look around. You can't look like that. You got to turn your head. What? Then you can look what? Look around. Look around and see. Is there someone you sense that the Holy Spirit wants you to shepherd? Don't assume, that person looks fine. Look around. Satellite church, look around. Don't assume. That person may have a shepherd. And sometimes a sheep can be shepherded by two people. Okay? If the Spirit of God wants you to do that, just do that. Some of you already have sheep in your hands. You're a befriender. Are you doing the right thing as a befriender? Are you shepherding well? Look around. You can start with looking around in the church. Then you can look around in your neighborhood. Look around in your workplace. Even look around in your own house. The people that you are living with, look around at your neighbors. They are lost. They don't believe in Jesus. God is going to judge between the sheep and sheep. Don't forget. And one can say, I didn't know that. To be a sheep enough. No. This chapter, Ezekiel 34, is about being a shepherd. It's not about being a sheep. So God's going to judge between the sheep and sheep. And you are living in the very last days. Use your time, your talents, and your treasures, O sheep, to become a shepherd. Because God is going to judge between the sheep and sheep.
今天我们在母教会或者我们的子教会的，你把你的眼神望向你四周的人，看看下上帝要放哪一个人成为你的羊群呢？因为今天我们的圣经告诉我们呢，我们今天所讲的是关于牧者，而不是关于羊群。所以呢，上帝会在我们这些牧者之间呢，也会做审判的。
Can we all rise up, please?
大家一起起立。
Rise up, hallelujah.